Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Ark the Lad Twilight of the Spirits with me, UltraGamerJ. In this episode, well, in our last episode, we began the first half of our trek through the volcano. But now we have reached the final half, or rather the latter half. And as you can see, Ben is sitting with me, watching all of this unfold.
I'm coming for you!
I wonder if those are the Deimos' pets. I did not forget about you. Oh, wow. Come on. Oh.
I'm coming for you. Go. Come on. Aw, missed the multi-hit. Oh! Look out!
Here I come.
Prepare yourself. Got it that time. Hi-ya! Wasn't a surprise. Ooh, class up for Paulette. Let's see what kind of benefits she gets, or what kind of skills she can learn. Let's see. Rain, let's see, here's some good charge. Still on guard. Yes, Ben, Paulette has become more of a badass now. Let's see. I guess we'll go with this. And for Maru, let's see. Hunting arrow. Still have to do the defensive stance first. That takes priority. Guns, you've got anything? Nope. And that's it. That is all. Let's make sure. Oh, yeah, I went into party items. What's this way? Absolute Jack. That is what is this. Oh, spoke too soon. Not that way. What's this way? Huh. Wonder if that would lead anywhere. Oh, hello. Turns out there is more to explore, silly me. Oh my. I wasn't trying to get in there. Actually, let's see what that was, because I'm legitimately curious. Is it in here? Oh, bro, we got two of those? Wait, I just scrolled past it. Oh. That's neat. Not sure how this. A mini statue of a falcon prevents silence, but okay. Actually, one of my. I'm supposed to. Duh. Give everyone a quick checkup. Clean bill of health. physically. Someone who would benefit from them. Let's do Paulette. She's reliable. Oh, wait. Okay, it is on now. Yeah, I've seen enough Ball Buddy comics or read them to know where such a scenario might lead for Tatjana. I am doubtful that you would, but curious that you may. Especially since I'm getting Shuten Doji vibes from the eldest brother. This is. And we are not within range. So let's take a step forward. And then. Oh, hell yeah.
Watch the arrows rain down! Binding arrows! On guard.
Actually, Paulette, that seems like a huge overestimation. I think, based on the weapons they're using, you would have a rough estimate of how they'll attack. I mean, bow and arrow, I mean, long distance attacker. That's just common sense. The one with the gourd, obviously close range fighter, since he's using that as a blunt instrument, and the one with the flail, that's mid range. Not too hard to figure out, just saying. And yes, given their size, yes, I mean you would have to be a bit more careful. Well, considering their range would be better than that of a normal human's. As well as the strength, or rather the centrifugal force behind their attacks. Or rather, how much weight they'd put behind it. You just need to keep. I mean, their attacks are not unpredictable. They're. You know what you're in for, but. You should still be on your toes.
Alright, let's concentrate.
Don't think I can hit them with that arrow again.
I'm coming for you.
Huh. Well, that's surprising. And again, they know this cave inside and out, so I guess that's to be expected. Maybe.
Come through.
Just by applying balm onto Karg. Oddly enough. Do I want to do that, or... You know what? I will.
Dancing Blade, destroy the enemy! Whirlwind Helmet Crusher!
Magic is no match for science! Sigma Gale!
Well, if magic can't lose or can't beat science, what if you used the two of them together? Just a thought. Let's see. Bone Crush, Skull Crush. Let's see. Ooh, this one. Let's do that.
My cut flesh is your broken bones.
Now I can hit you with that arrow. Oh, jeez.
Watch the arrows rain down! Binding arrow!
Given that there are fire users, something tells me using fire moves, which Paulette excels at, would probably be counterproductive, at best. Let's see, interceptor stance. Let's do the interceptor just to be safe. Do you warrant a special move? I suppose you do.
Dancing Blade, destroy the enemy! Whirlwind Helmet Crusher!
I want to point out that I did not make her, like, end that speech bubble too soon. That was just the game itself. Seems kind of rude for it to do that, but... Yeah, we kind of got the gist of what Tatjana was saying. Huh? What the? Oh, there we go. Oh, crap. Low on Spirit Stone ammunition. Well, I just set myself up for that, didn't I?
You can't stop me.
Ooh, you're a tough one.
Can't you do better than that?
Do not screw with Paulette. That is the moral of the story of this the moral of this episode. It's an item of some significance.
Go! Aw, man! All right, who's first?
Let's see what we got here. That is not heat-related. Mind scan, that could work. Wait, what was that one? Morale's already been boosted, so I don't think I need to. Let's try Stinging Rain. See if that's not fire attributed.
Oh, shooting stars, smash our enemies! Stinging Rain!
Oh, good, it's not! Good. Thankfully, I have ways of fixing that. That was a lot of healing you did. Huh? Very good. Good for you. Good for this team.
Once I get you, you'll never escape.
Oh shit. That was fire attributed. Oh, crap!
I won't forget this humiliation.
Tatiana is down for the count.
Let's go, Paulette!
I'll follow your lead. Ha! Ha!
Oh.
Is this edible?
Another potential good thing. Well, let's test that little theory of yours.
I'll grind you to find power. Skull crush.
Maybe it was Stinging Rain. I think that's maybe what I mistook it as.
I'll show you the dance of shooting stars. Stinging Rain!
Yep. I mistook that one attack for Stinging Rain. That is what happened. Actually, why do that when I can do the next? Something even better. Oh no, I can't do Healing Rain. Shit. Huh. Still go with the good old cure.
May a healing wind blow and rain down new strength. Cure!
Oh shit, Maru needs a pick-me-up.
Knock their socks off to protect our loved ones.
Oh wow.
tough stop.
Hot damn. That's a reward for teamwork. I mean, technically speaking, she already kind of shot Karg multiple times. I mean, there was that one incident, for example. Just saying. So, I mean, getting shot at by Tachana shouldn't really... isn't that big of a deal? I mean, it's really to be expected. Get everyone fixed up. That battle really took a lot out of us. Got our asses kicked pretty good. Well, not kicked, but much better than that one time. I will say that much. Oh, yeah, a silk bowstring for Maru, that makes sense. Antique blade for Gons, good for him. Let's put those on. Aiding guard support. Let's get rid of critical hit support. Actually, what would that do? It just brings down the crit rate. Place this with the heat blade. And then let's put back that, let's reapply that stone coating. And we are good to go. Assuming there's any more attacks. Oh, we can take defensive stance too. Let's do that. Got anything new, Gons? Oh, you finally learned first aid. You'd think being a soldier, you'd even know that. You'd know the basic concept of that. But whatever. Wait, did I fill up the spirit stone? Yes, I did. Okay. I didn't have a chance to say this before, but with the appearance of Emperor Darkham, I would like to reiterate that on this channel, all dictatorships are bad. Fascism is bad. Emperor Darkham is a bad person, and not just because he looks like a certain figure from World War II. Yeah, besides, the Firestone's not... A Firestone isn't that useful in the realm of Pokémon. It only evolves like a few Pokémon as opposed to like a Waterstone or a Thunderstone. Or Leaf, Moon, Sun, Dawn, and Duskstones. Oh, and the Sparkling Stone, too. Where's its Shining Stone? I'm pretty sure he would. I mean, he'd probably do it even if it was Maru or Gons. Thank you for the kiss, Jerry. Is that Tatiana over there? I need to get a good look. Well, that was bound to happen. That was a foregone conclusion. Although I wonder how that Dilswald soldier managed to set the bomb underneath the bridge when there were barely any gaps in the planks of that bridge. Who knows? Come on, let me talk to Paulette. Let me talk to the MVP of this team. Dang you. Damn it. That's a nice sentiment. Come on, let me talk to Maru. And how do you suppose we do that? What, are we supposed to just assume there's like some secret exit panel right up here at this altar? I mean, there probably is, but still. Good thought process to have, Gons. Rapier would be proud. Now what are we supposed to do? There wasn't some secret panel to get out of this Temple of Doom. Really, you shouldn't be surprised that... Honestly, Tachana should not be surprised that Darkham threw her away. I mean, she knew what she signed up for, right? Right? How are we supposed to be? Is there some sort of trick to getting out of here? Huh. Well, that was a convenient rescue. But I'm not gonna complain. Didn't join the party. Usually when someone goes into Karg's body, they join the party. Unless they're Lilia. Well, that was quite the episode we had there. Can't believe it was almost an... This recording is almost an hour. But, yeah. I did not think clearing the volcano was going to take that long, but... we did it, at least. So I'm going to end the episode here. This has been UltraGamerJ signing off, hoping to see you all in the next episode. And please remember to like and subscribe for more content.